Hello students, right from today we are going to discuss or start with a new topic of physics section first, that is gravitation. I know that you have an idea about this gravitation in your 10th standard also. Some of the aspect you have discussed in 10th standard. Moreover, in detail we will have certain aspects regarding the gravitation in your 11th standard. So basically, what is this gravitation and gravitational force? We know that all objects, they are having a tendency to fall towards the earth. It means they get attracted towards the earth. This is the most common example that we know. Any ball thrown vertically upward, it will fall on the surface of ground, or any object we are throwing vertically upward, it will ultimately fall on the surface of ground. Or say fruits are falling from the tree, raindrops are falling from the cloud. See, these examples gives us an idea that every object, it has a tendency to fall or to attract towards the earth. Why does this happen? So the base of this is nothing but there must be a certain force which attract the bodies. Which force is this? Nothing but a gravitational force. Means every object attracting towards the earth is falling or attracting with a constant acceleration, and that acceleration we call it as acceleration due to gravity, that is G. It is acceleration due to gravity, having specific value on the different values on the surface of earth. That is also you have studied in your 10th standard. So this is what a constant acceleration, and about which scientist Aryabhatta, he has given us an idea that any object, it is falling towards the earth with this constant acceleration due to gravity. Accordingly, he has also studied about the revolution of earth, revolution of moon, that is earth is revolving around the sun, moon is revolving around the earth. These phenomenon are just due to the existence of the acceleration due to gravity, or say gravitational force exists between any two objects. It means this is a mutual force. It lies between any two objects. Now from the macroscopic to microscopic object, what exists is the gravitational force. Any two objects, say very, very short up to the atomic nuclear objects to macroscopic, means up to the celestial bodies, say heavenly bodies, means planets, asteroids, comets and all these things. So between any these objects, what exists is nothing but the force of attraction, and this force of attraction is nothing but the gravitational force, which compels this massive object to attract to each other, and they can have their motions in a particular orbits and all these things. And we found the planetary motions, that is different planets are revolving around the sun. So one more thing, the Galileo scientist, he has given an idea by the demonstration that say suppose two objects, we have fallen from a certain height, obviously from the same height two balls are say dropped, and observed that when they reaches to the ground, how these objects are, they are having different masses. One is having same mass m1, another is having same mass m2. These two objects, when they are dropped from the same vertical height, we found or we think that a massive object, means the object which is having more mass, will reach the ground first. But this will never occur. That is, both reaches the ground at the same time, if there is no frictional resistance or any other type of resistive force. असा जर resistive force obstacle जर काही नसेल, काही अडथळा नसेल, तर same vertical height पासून drop केलेले दोन objects ground वर केव्हा fall होतात at the same time. So all these things regard or leads nothing but they are falling with the same acceleration, and this acceleration is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity. Here scientists, we know that Newton, he has accordingly given the law of gravitation. From this study of the acceleration of the moon, this is acceleration of moon with which it is revolving around the earth, from this study he has given a law, and this law we call it as a universal law of gravitation. Why universal? It means it is applicable from microscopic objects to macroscopic objects, that is for every particle of matter. This law is applicable, and thereby we call it as this law is a universal law, and that is nothing but Newton's law of gravitation. This law also helps us to study further about the planetary motions, that is how the planets are revolving around the sun. And this study also, for this study also, Kepler has the base of Newton's law of gravitation. Accordingly, he has given the three different laws of planetary motion. Those we will discuss further. So first of all, you have an idea about this Newton's law of gravitation, which states that every particle of matter, means not only the two objects, see here, suppose this is a one object, this is an another object, they are separated by a distance, say, from where we will have to take the distance. This distance r is to be taken from the center of gravity of the two objects, that is from the center to center. From the center of gravity, suppose the two objects are separated by a distance r having masses say m1 and mass m2, then what the law states is, this is what a line joining the center to center, we can say this distance is, the two objects are along a straight line, thereby every particle of matter, means from this object every particle of matter attracts every particle, other particle of the matter with a force. With a force, this attraction is with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses. Both are having masses m1 and m2. So directly proportional to product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Means F is directly proportional to m1 m2 upon r square. See here, this law, as we have discussed, it is applicable for every particle of matter, every object. Therefore, not only the objects which are thrown at a particular distance or nearer to the earth, we have thrown and they are falling on the earth. This is not the case. This law is applicable for celestial bodies also, any massive objects also, which are having very, very heavy masses. Therefore, these are applicable for the planetary motions also. Such a force, this force, nothing but the gravitational force, which is directly proportional to product of the masses of the two objects and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. This is what the statement of the Newton's law of gravitation, and from this we can write here the constant of proportionality as C, F is equal to this proportionality sign constant is replaced by equality sign. Therefore, F is equal to M1, M2 divided by R square, and for this constant of proportionality, we can write G. Means F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square. What is this G is? G is nothing but universal gravitational constant. This is what? Universal gravitational constant. In many formula we replace the constant of proportionality and that we call it as a constant of proportionality, but here we have specified as a universal constant. Why? Because its value never changes at anywhere in the universe, and having value G is equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to power minus 11. What must be the unit? Newton meter square per kilogram square. How? See here. Means we can take the formula for G as a G is equal to F R square divided by M1 M2. It means this is what a force. R is the distance between the two objects. M1 and M2 are the masses. Therefore, G must have the unit. Force has unit Newton. R means distance. Therefore, meter square and per kilogram square. So, Newton meter square per kilogram square. This is the unit of constant of proportionality, that is universal gravitational constant. This differs from this G. This G and G has different values. G is not a constant. It is an acceleration due to gravity whose value changes from the surface of the earth, from one point to another point on the surface of the earth. It is having different value on the equator, having different value on the poles, and likewise that we will discuss furthermore. So thereby we can't say G is having a constant value, but this G, capital G, denoted by capital G, which is universal gravitational constant, has value 6.67 10 raised to minus 11, which is a constant one. We can find out. From this, we can find out the dimensions of this G also. What are the dimensions of G? We can find it out from this formula. See, F, that is force, has dimension M1, L1, T raised to minus 2. We have found out in our units and dimension. Then R square means L2. Then kilogram, it is nothing but kg, means it is m2. Fine. So from this we can write m to the power minus 1, l to the power 3, and t raised to minus 2. So this is how m minus 1, l 3, t raised to minus 2 are the dimensions of universal gravitational constant. See here, likewise, this is what the basic formula, F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square, which is nothing but the gravitational force with which the two objects get attracted towards each other. See, what does it mean? Which type of force is this? Gravitational force. Which type of force is this? This is an attractive force. Gravitational force is an attractive force. Means from this we can find out the characteristics of gravitational force. Those are nothing but it is an attractive force. Gravitational force is an attractive force. Means the any two objects get attracted towards each other by a force, and this force is nothing but the gravitational force. What is about the range of this gravitational force? Means up to what distance the two objects get attracted towards each other? दोनी मधे किती अंतर असलं पाहिजे दोन ऑब्जेक्ट्स मधे ज्यामुळे त्यामध्ये फोर्स ऑफ अट्रॅक्शन असेल, दॅट इज ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स विल एक्झिस्ट. दॅट इज इट्स अ व्हेरी लॉन्ग, व्हेरी व्हेरी लॉन्ग रेंज फोर्स, व्हेरी लॉन्ग रेंज फोर्स मीन्स वन ऑब्जेक्ट मे बी सिच्युएटेड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ अर्थ अँड अनदर मे बी अ सेलेस्टियल बॉडी ऑल्सो, देअर ऑल्सो वॉट एक्झिस्ट इज नथिंग बट द ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स. मीन्स दिस इज अ व्हेरी लॉन्ग रेंज फोर्स. फाईन, हे कुठल्याही दोन ऑब्जेक्ट कितीही अंतरावर असतील तरी त्यामध्ये काय एक्झिस्ट करतं तर ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स. देअर बाय वी कॅन से दॅट ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स इज अ लॉन्ग रेंज फोर्स. देन इट इज द विकेस्ट फोर्स इन द युनिवर्स. इट इज द विकेस्ट फोर्स इन द युनिवर्स. Weakest means which force with which we are going to compare these gravitational forces. Say strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force, electromagnetic force and gravitational force. These are four real forces. We will discuss about the real forces and pseudo forces later on. So right now keep it in mind that gravitational force is a real force, means whose interaction it arises due to known interaction, its origin can be known. Such a force is a real force. This out of these real forces, it is the weakest force in the universe. Means what? It is of the order of 10 raised to minus 39 times weaker than that of strong nuclear force. Kiti times it is too much weaker. How much times? 10 to the power minus 39 times weaker than that of the strong nuclear force. And one more thing about the gravitational force is that it is independent of intervening medium. Independent of intervening medium means what? Intervening means हस्तक्षेप. म्हणजे दोन ऑब्जेक्ट्स मध्ये जो ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स एक्झिस्ट करणार आहे, अट्रॅक्टिव्ह फोर्स असणार आहे, तो कशावर अवलंबून नाही? मेडियमवर अवलंबून नाही. इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द इंटरव्हेनिंग मेडियम. This is how the specifications or certain characteristics of gravitational force are there, which is the most important thing, that is due to this gravitational existence of the gravitational force which compels the object to attract each other. One more thing you can think that if there exist gravitational force between any two objects, say suppose we people and the wall, आपण घरामध्ये बसलोय, वॉल आपल्याला अट्रॅक्ट करते का? इज देअर ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स एक्झिस्ट बिटवीन द वॉल अँड वी पीपल? येस, इट अट्रॅक्ट्स. देन विल इट मूव टुवर्ड्स इच अदर? नो. वाय? बिकॉज दिस इज वॉट? इट इज द विकेस्ट फोर्स. देअर फोर वी कांट एक्सपिरियन्स हा वॉलने आपल्याला वर एक्झर्ट केलेल्या ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्सचा जो इफेक्ट आहे तो आपण काय करत नाही? एक्सपिरियन्स करत नाही. का? बिकॉज इट इज द विकेस्ट फोर्स इन द युनिवर्स. सो दीज आर सर्टन कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स. सो ड्यू टू द एक्झिस्टन्स ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स ऑर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द साइंटिस्ट केपलर, ही हॅज गिवन अस अन आयडिया अबाउट द प्लॅनेटरी मोशन, हाऊ द प्लॅनेट्स आर रिव्हॉल्विंग अराउंड द सन, अबाउट विच ही हॅज गिवन द थ्री डिफरंट लॉज. दोज वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ.